Hello students, welcome back to maths class. In this video we will see the properties of rational number for class 8th. Okay, so firstly once again we will revise what is rational numbers. Rational numbers can be represented in the form of p upon q. Those number who can represent in the form of p upon q, where p and q both are integers and q will not be equal to zero. So that kind of numbers is known as rational number. For example, minus 3 by 5, 1 upon 2, 7 upon 3. 0 also a rational number because it has a denominator of 1. Its numerator is 0 but denominator is 1. Okay, so they all are rational numbers example. So firstly we will see closure property. Closure property said us if any two numbers are of the same kind. Here we are looking for the rational number, so we will take A and B as a rational number. If A and B both are rational number, so their result will be also a rational number. Okay, if we are applying addition, so A plus B answer will be also a rational number. Answer should be a rational number. So here we are taking two examples. Where we taken A as a 2 upon 3 and B as a 4 upon 3. Okay. So here our operations are addition. Under the addition we will add A plus B. A plus B. The value of A is 2 upon 3 plus value of B which is 4 upon 3. Base is same, so it will comes 3 one time. So 3 is coming here one time. 2 plus 4 is 6. When we reduce it, we will get 2. And 2 is also a rational number because it has a denominator of 1. If we are not looking at any denominator like here, we don't see any denominator. It means that it has a denominator of 1. 0. Here you can simply see it does not have any denominator but it has always. Okay, it has 1. So that's why 2 is also a rational number. It means we take a rational number and after applying the addition we get again a rational number. It means yes. Under the addition, our closure property is satisfying for the rational number. Now for the subtraction, A minus B. Simply 2 upon 3 minus 4 upon 3. Denominator is same, so it will comes 3 times. And plus minus, positive 2 minus 4. Plus minus is minus, so that 4 minus 2 is 2. And 4 is the greater number, so its symbol will come here. So we will get minus 2 upon 3. We take a rational number and we get answer as a rational number. Minus 2 and 3 both are rational number and our denominator is a integer. 0 nahi hai, integer hai. That's why yes. Under the subtraction, our closure property is satisfying for the rational number. Same for the multiplication, we will multiply A by B so that we will get 2 into 3 multiplies by 4 by 3. In the multiplication, we are simply multiplying numerator by numerator, denominator by denominator. So that 2 4s are 8, 3 3s are 9, which is also a rational number. So that yes. Under the multiplication, our closure property is satisfying for the rational number. Now for the next operator, division. Here we taken two cases. First case, according to condition that we taken as 2 upon 3 and 4 upon 3. Simply, when we divide A by B, It means 2 upon 3 divides by 4 upon 3. Now, we have to take the reciprocal of second term. Reciprocal of second term. Okay? Reciprocal means just we have to send numerator in the denominator and denominator into numerator after changing its symbol. Okay? Here we have symbol as a division, so it will change into multiplication. 3 will comes in the numerator and 4 will comes in the denominator. 3 to 3 we will cut and we will get 2 upon 4 or 1 upon 2. We take a rational number and we got rational number. So this is one case. But in another hand, if we have a rational number 2 upon 3 and b a rational number 0. Okay, 0 is also a rational number because it has a denominator of 1. So when we divide 2 upon 3 by 0, what we will get? We will get 0 in the denominator. It means it will not consider, it will not define. That's why here we get one case as a yes, another case is a no. So contradiction is there. One case is telling us it is satisfying. And another case is telling us no, it is not satisfying. That's why the completely we will know it under the division. Our closure property is not satisfying for the rational number. Now the next property is commutative property. Commutative property said us if we are applying a plus b, it means that it will be equal to b plus a. If we are applying a minus b, so it will be also equal as b minus a. Okay, same, if we are applying a multiplied by b, so it should be equal to b multiplied by a. We are just simply shuffling the places of values and result, we want result as a equal. So for that we taken a as a 5 upon 2, b as a 7 upon 2. For that addition, simply a plus b is equal to b plus a. That is the property that we want. Simply we will put the values on the both side. Here you can see our denominator is same, so it will comes 2 times. And 5 plus 7 is 12. 12 will divide by 2 and gives us 6. Opposite side we are also getting 6. So we taken rational numbers and after shuffling their places we got again rational number because it has denominator of 1 and both are equal to each other. Both are equal to each other, that's why yes. Same we will do for the subtraction. On the place of addition, we have to write subtraction. Okay? A minus B is equal to B minus A. Simply, we will put the values of A and B. Okay? You can simply see, base is same, so it will comes 2 times. Okay? Positive 5 minus 7. Plus minus is minus. So, 7 minus 5 is 2. And 7 is the greater number, so its symbol will come here. When we divide minus 2 by 2, we will get minus 1. Okay? Opposite side we have. Denominator is same, so it will comes 2 time, 1 time. 2 comes 1 time. Okay? Simply we have to write 2 only single time. 7 minus 5 is 2. When we reduce 2 by 2, we will get 1. Okay, you can simply see both are rational number. They both are rational number but not equal to each other. Okay, here this side is negative and this side is positive. That's why no, under the subtraction our commutative property is not satisfying for the rational number. Next property for the multiplication. A multiplied by B is equal to b multiplied by a. Simply we will put the values and multiply numerator to numerator, denominator to denominator. so that 5 7s are 35, 2 2s are 4. This side also 7 5s are 35, 2 2s are 4. We get both side as a rational number and equal to each other. So that yes, under the multiplication our commutative property is satisfying for the rational number. Now the last operator is division. When we will divide A divided by B is equal to B divided by A. Simply we will put the values. Okay, one rational number is dividing by another on the both side. So we will take the reciprocal of second term. Okay, both side we will take the reciprocal of second term, and always we have to take the reciprocal of second term. Okay, so our 7 upon 2 is changed into 2 upon 7 and division is changed into multiplication. So 2 to 2 we can cut and we have 5 upon 7. This side our 5 upon 2 is changed into 2 upon 5. We will simply cut 2 to 2 and we will get 7 upon 5. They both are rational number. They both are rational number but not equal to each other. That's why no, under the division our commutative property is not satisfying for the rational numbers. Now the next property is associative properties. Okay, in this we have with the A, B, C also. Okay, with A, B we have C also. Okay, so we have to take three values of the rational number that we taken 3 upon 4, 2 upon 4, 5 upon 4. Okay, so the first property for the addition is A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. Simply we are changing the places of bracket. Okay, firstly we taken last two numbers B and C together. And the next one we taken A plus B together. Now we will put the values of A, B, C on the both side. Okay, which will give us 3 upon 4 plus 2 upon 4 plus 5 upon 4 is equal to 3 upon 4 plus 2 upon 4 plus 5 upon 4. Now firstly we will solve the bracket. We will get 2 plus 5 as a 7. Denominator is same, so it will comes one time. Again 3 plus 7 is 10. Denominator is same, so it will comes one time. So gives us 10 upon 4. Opposite side we have 3 plus 2 which will gives us 5. Denominator is same, so it will comes one time. Remaining one is 5 upon 4. So here we have 5 upon 4. 5 plus 5 is 10 and denominator is same, so it will comes one time. So we have both side as a rational number and equal to each other. That means that yes, under the addition our associative property is satisfying. Now the subtraction. For the subtraction we will put all over the symbol as negative. A minus B minus C, A minus B minus C. Simply we will put the values. Now we will solve the bracket. 2 minus 5 plus minus minus. Okay, 5 minus 2 is 3 and symbol of 5. So minus 3 upon 4. When we open the bracket we will get 3 upon 4 plus 3 upon 4. 3 plus 3 is 6. 4 will comes one time because both numbers are having same denominator, so it will comes one time. We can also reduce 6 upon 4 as a 3 upon 2. Okay, opposite side we have 3 minus 2, so that we get 1 upon 4. 1 minus 5 is minus 4 upon 4 which will gives us minus 1. You can simply see one side we have 3 upon 2 or 6 upon 4 and another side we have minus 1. They both are rational number but not equal to each other. That's why no, under the subtraction our associative property is not satisfying for the rational number. Now the multiplication. Simply we will multiply A by B by C. We will get 2 5s are 10, 4 4s are 16. Then 3 10s are 30, 4 16s is 64. Opposite side also, 3 2s are 6, 4 4s are 16, 6 5s are 30, 16 4s are 64. You can simply see our both hands are equal to each other and also a rational number. That's why yes. Now for the division, we will divide A divide by B divide by C. Simply we will put the values and firstly we will solve the bracket. Okay, so taking reciprocal in bracket. Okay, we are taking the reciprocal in bracket. So our 5 by 4 is changed into 4 by 5 and here 2 upon 4 is changed into 4 upon 2. And in the bracket our division is changed into multiplication. So 4 to 4 we will cut and we will get 2 upon 5. Here 4 to 4 we will cut and we have 3 upon 2. Again we will take the reciprocal and this time we have to take the reciprocal of major terms. Okay, here we don't have any bracket, so we will take the reciprocal. Our 2 upon 5 is changed into 5 upon 2 and here 5 upon 4 is changed into 4 upon 5 and division is changed into multiplication. 3 5s are 15, 4 2s are 8, 3 2s are 6 and 5 1 is 5. 5 will comes only. Okay, you can simply see they both are rational number but not equal to each other. That's why no, under the division our associative property is not satisfying for the rational number. Now we will see the remaining properties, which are role of zero. Okay, role of zero. We have two cases. If we are adding zero, so there is no changes in the result. 0 plus 1 is 1 or 1 plus 0 is 1. But when we are multiplying by 0, okay, when we are multiplying by 0, on that time 14 will multiply by 0 will gives us 0. Here our number is changed as 0. Okay, but in the first case when we are adding 0, on that time our number is remain same. Okay, if we are multiplying 0 by 14, again we get 0. Okay, so this is the rule of 0, where when we multiply any rational number with 1, okay, rule of 0, when we are adding or multiplying by any number by 0, in the case of addition our number is same and in the case of multiplication our number is changed into zero. Now the next property is role of one. Okay, simply when we are multiplying any number by one, there is a none of the changes in the number. When we multiply any rational number or any whole number, natural number with one, so we will get back the rational number or a number as product. Okay, simply we are getting the answer as a product of the number and 1. So 42 multiplied by 1 is 42, or 1 into 42 is 42. Next case, minus 96 when multiplied by 1, it will gives us same, minus 96. Next is negative of a number. Negative of a number is, while we are studying the integers, on that time we know about the negatives. Okay, so we simply say the opposite. Okay, opposite of 1 is minus 1, अपोजिट ऑफ 2 इज -2 और अपोजिट ऑफ -2 इज 2. 2 का अपोजिट -2 है और -2 का अपोजिट कौन है? 2. सो व्हेन वी आर एडिंग देम ऑन दैट टाइम वी आर गेटिंग 0. सिंपली 3 अपोजिट इज -3 एंड व्हेन वी आर एडिंग देम वी गेट 0. 4 प्लस -4. 4 एंड -4 आर अपोजिट टू ईच अदर एंड व्हेन वी आर एडिंग देम वी गेट 0. -25 एंड 25 आर अपोजिट ऑफ ईच अदर एंड व्हेन वी आर एडिंग देम वी गेट 0. सो द अपोजिट ऑफ ईच अदर इज नोन एज एडिटिव इनवर्स. ओके, एडिटिव इनवर्स. After adding opposite numbers, we get 0. That's why it is known as additive inverse. Now, multiplicative inverse. It is also known as reciprocal. Okay? Reciprocal. So, if we have a by 1 multiplies by 1 by a, simply you see we reciprocal. A comes as a denominator, 1 comes as a numerator. So when we multiply these kinds of number to each other, on that time our product is 1. Okay? Our number is 2 and 2 reciprocal of 2 is 1 by 2. When we are multiplying the number and its reciprocal, we get 1. So 1 upon 2 is the multiplicative inverse of 2. Next number is 3 upon 6. When we take the reciprocal of 3 upon 6, we get 6 upon 3. And when we are multiplying number, it's reciprocal, so we will get 1. Because 6 to 6 cut, 3 to 3 cut. One more example we taken, 4 upon 7. Multiplies by 7 upon 4. Okay, 4 upon 7 is the number, and when we multiply it by its reciprocal, we will get 1. Okay, so 6 upon 3, 7 upon 4 are the multiplicative inverse of their number. Now, the next property is distributive property of multiplication over addition. Okay, we are looking for the distributive property of multiplication over addition. For that, we taken 3 integers a, b and c. Then, we will multiply a in b plus c. One number is multiplying in the addition of 2. So, a firstly will go near to b. So it will be a multiplied by b plus as it is. Then secondly, a will go near to c and gives us a multiplied by c. Same we will see for the distributive property of multiplication over subtraction, which is a multiplied by b minus c. So firstly, a will multiply in the b, then subtraction. A multiply by C. So here we completed all over the properties for the chapter. If you have any doubt, you can ask. I hope you understood. In the next video, we will see exercise 1.1 for the class 8.